Hello everyone, I'm the Gaming Beaver, and I was going to start this video completely differently. However, Jurassic World Evolution have just posted this video on their Twitter page.
Extracting species profile. Triceratops, a horned and armored genus of herbivorous ceratopsid from the late Cretaceous period of North America.
And it shows us just what would happen when we discover a new dinosaur, in this case, a Triceratops, giving us a little brief synopsis about said dinosaur, as well as a really good look at it in-game. Not much to say about it, it's just getting me more excited for the game! Thought I'd throw that in just because it's fresh off the press. And now onto the rest of the video, and those Funko Pops. Except for it's not leaked stuff. So, I'm not gonna get my video taken down again. Damn it, Universal, stop it! Anyway. So first off, let's talk about the Funko Pops that are being released for the 25th anniversary of Jurassic Park. And for those of you that don't know what Funko Pops is, well, oh boy. Funko Pops managed to take the world by storm. Here's an analogy for you. Do you remember an art class where you know somebody, or not even an art class, you just know somebody who draws this particular way, and no matter what they draw, they always have a certain style to it? Well, that's basically Funko Pop. They have the license to pretty much everything, and they just recreate it in this same dead-eyed stare look to them. And funnily enough, they haven't ever done Jurassic Park Funko Pops, and this is the first time they're ever doing it. Which is really strange because they have pretty much every sort of franchise license that you can think of. So how did they get so popular? Well, for a start, pretty much anything you can think of, they have it. You like Jurassic Park? Well, they're gonna have it soon. Back to the Future, they've got it. Simpsons, they've got it. Disney, they've got it. Anything you can think of, anything you like, it's a Funko Pop. And the second reason why they're so popular is that they resonate with collectors. Funko Pop have been known to release limited editions of certain types of the Funko Pops in different locations like Comic-Cons and different stores, exclusives, making those ones sought after. And even people who just want to make a quick buck on them as well, deliberately track them down, hoard them for a while, and then sell them for ridiculous prices on eBay. So with that kind of out of the way, let's talk about the new Jurassic Park 25th anniversary editions of Funko Pop. First off, we have to start with the Alan Grant, sporting his amazing hat. He's also got his raptor claw, his little red neckerchief, his blue denim jackety thing. I don't know what you'd call it, shirt. He's also got his watch and his little pocket trowel in his belt. So they've spent a lot of time getting down every little detail with this character, which is something I've got to admire them for. Next, we've got Dennis Nedry, sporting the right kind of glasses. Now, I'm not sure if those glasses are going to be white on the underneath. I think they should be see-through. I just can't really remember Dennis Nedry's glasses. I know that Lowry in Jurassic World wears them, and it's a sort of Easter egg if you ever notice that. But of course, Dennis Nedry's sporting his yellow rain jacket, and of course, the Barbasol cryo can, as well as his ID badge. I was kind of expecting if they were going to do a Dennis Nedry, that they would have him in his chair, just surrounded by a pile of junk, and maybe a desk. But obviously, they've already got this blueprint ready to go, so they just slapped on some extra stuff for Dennis Nedry. But I mean, it would have been cool. It definitely would have been a collector's edition to have. Now, let's get on to the interesting ones. We have the Velociraptor. Now, this is where Funko Pops start to really shine, because I'm not one for their human characters, but they're sort of unique ones with dinosaurs or any sort of monster. It kind of works better. I don't know about you, but I always find that the creatures work better than the humans. And this one actually has had a change. When they first put out images, they did the Hasbro thing. They put the raptor without the sickle claw, but as you can see right here, they have actually changed it. So that's quite nice that they fixed that. I'm hoping that maybe we'll get a limited edition version that'll be the big one. I mean, if Pop really want to go all out, and if they know their lore, then that's something that they're gonna do. And I'd be snapping up that one and selling that one in eBay! And moving on to the second dinosaur, it is the Dilophosaurus, which looks so cute because his little snout is all like, it's as if somebody's got an elastic band and just squished his little nose. I quite like the coloring in the model. The one of the packaging as well is also nice, so whichever one they go for, I'll be happy to pick that one up. And moving on to the one that the Funko experts, which I am not, sort of put together two and two. They were like, well, there's no Ellie Sattler, she'll probably be with a Jeep. And would you believe, here she is with said Jeep Wrangler Sahara sand beige. But there is still a problem with this one. Yes, it has the square YJ lights. If it was a TJ, it would have circular headlights. Yes, it has the Ramsey rep winch on the front, as well as the OEM fog lights that go along the chassis at the front. But this is the one that the T-Rex chases, hence the cases on the back of the Jeep. The only problem with this is that they've numbered this Jeep 18. And we all know, or at least if you're a hardcore fan of Jurassic Park, and especially in the vehicles department like me, you'll know that Jeep 18 is the Jeep that housed Ellie Sattler, Ian Malcolm, and Alan Grant. And this isn't the first time that they've changed that number over. I can't remember what it was the first time, but if this is supposed to be that Jeep, the one that has Ian Malcolm in the back when he's like, you know what that is? That's an impact tremor when this is what that is. Then this needs to be the JP10. A little fix, but I'm hoping they do fix that one. Moving on to the other big one, which is the T-Rex. I don't really have much to say about this one. It's still got the cute little elastic band jaw that the Dilophosaurus sport. And by the looks of it, this T-Rex is going to be a lot bigger than the Dilophosaur and the Velociraptor, which would make sense. T-Rex is bigger. But there's also been word circulating that it's not, and it's going to be exactly the same size. So we don't really know what really is going on here. It would be nice if it was a big one, though. Moving on to our star, the luscious Ian Malcolm. Ooh, and unfortunately, yes, he doesn't have his top off. But I mean, we can make our own custom ones, right? Yeah. Sporting his amazing dark attire with his black leather jacket and his incredibly masculine and not effeminate in any way necklace. And of course he has his rings, another little bit of attention to detail that I really like. And moving on to the final one, and that is John Hammond with his little wicker hat, his amber cane, and his golden wristwatch. Me personally, I'm not a fan of Funko, even though I actually have some. I do have some Dragon Ball ones. When it comes to certain franchises, I'm gonna collect them just because I like them. And these Jurassic Park ones, even though I'm not really much of a fan of Funko Pop, I am probably going to get every last one of these. Don't know why, I just have a problem. I seem to buy all these toys and stuff and then have nowhere to put them. And Whitney hates me for it. So guys, let me know what your thoughts are on the Funko Pops and which ones you're gonna pick up. If not all of them, of course. I mean, that is the right answer we're looking for here. But that is not the only newest sort of release thing we've got of toys for celebrating the Jurassic Park franchise 25th anniversary, maybe? It could be just for Jurassic World. Now, if you remember, Hasbro lost the license to the Jurassic Park franchise, and kind of rightly so. All the toys were pretty lackluster, and whether that was actually Universal saving face or not, who knows? But anyway, the toys weren't too great, and Mattel have taken over, and let me tell you, they do not want anybody to know what kind of toys they're making. But this one seems to be everywhere, and it's no spoiler to the movie, so I'm pretty safe in assuming I can post this one. So their sub company Fisher-Price has added the iconic Jurassic Park Jeep to their Power Wheels line. These are intended for kids and they're like little electric cars that they can sit in and drive around. I'm sure you've seen them. And even grown men have redone the Barbie Jeep, I think, to look like the Jurassic Park Jeep. I know some people in the Jurassic Park motor pool have done that and it looks amazing. And me, oh, I've already had my fair share of electric cars like the BMW i8. So I can't wait for this thing to come out and just have loads of fun sitting in it. This time we actually have an official release. There is, however, a few problems with this one. Being the nerd that I am, I'm gonna point them out to you. Yay! For a start, this is supposed to be Jeep 18. And for the most part, I mean, yeah, they got the colorings right. But the front of the Jeep, is that not of a YJ? No, that is a TJ. If you didn't know what YJ and a TJ is, a YJ is basically the one in Jurassic Park. And then a couple of years after that, they recreated the Jeep Wrangler Sahara in the TJ version. And thus they changed the square iconic headlights to the round ones. And they would then keep them until up to this day. I think even the Jeep Wranglers now have the round headlights. Not only that, but they don't have the front fog headlights, they don't have the winch. I mean, it is Jeep 18, and so it wouldn't have had a soft top on it anyway. But it has, like, lights on the top, which the Jeep 18, I'm pretty sure, didn't have. It had a light bar, but no headlights on it. But anyway, I mean, this is all, I mean, do kids really care about screen accuracy? Not really, James, shut up. But just on a side note, I really like the little addition of the T-Rex and the mirrors. It's really good. But anyway, I'm really glad this thing exists, and I cannot wait to buy one and drive around. Yeah! That is not the last of the things I want to go over. A user on Twitter who goes by @thepastrypossum managed to find those infamous remake DVDs of the Jurassic Park franchise. You remember the ones with the terrible covers? Well, he actually managed to find one of them, and for the first time, we've got a glimpse of the back of the case. And oh my god, it's glorious! Whoever is in charge of these has done a terrible, terrible job of Photoshop cutting out one of the stegosaurs. If you remember, this stegosaur is cut from a scene where there is loads of stegosaurs. And obviously this was a rush job. This person didn't know where one stegosaur started and the other one ended. And somehow this person gave the stegosaur a really weird triangular shaped head. The more I look at it, the more ridiculous it becomes. We'll just flick between the movie shot and the shot that they crop, and it's just like, how did you do this? The more I look at these DVD covers, the more I'm convinced that Universal would just, they had some sort of intern, and they were like, ah, we don't have time for this, you do it. Like, you had to crop its head in half, and then, for some odd reason, give it extra spikes? I mean, you can quite clearly see where the spikes are. Oh, it just takes that beautiful special touch to make Pinhead Stego a thing. And with that, we need more stuff like this.
Welcome to Pinhead.
Go, go, Pinhead. You call him Pinhead. You call him Pinhead.
All right, Pinhead. Your time is up.
Who you calling Pinhead?
I need to find this in person. I'm going to go out and just search for this DVD and the other ones as well. We need to see what kind of crazy dinosaur abominations Universal have created. And just when I thought I could wrap up the video, Funko Pop themselves on their Twitter page posted the Jurassic Park figures, showing that there will be some sort of limited edition, only a Target, Dennis Nedry, Dilophosaur, and our favorite, Topless Ian Malcolm, yes!
Praise be to Raptor Jesus.
So guys, if you've enjoyed this video, leave a like. Thanks again for all the support you leave on my videos and series and all that jazz. I love you. And until next time, where there are more like Jurassic dinosaur news and whatever will come out, I'll see you later. Bye-bye.